I do that a lot.
Augustus was
confused.
He was outgoing. He was fun-loving.
Eccentric.
Eccentric.
Eccentric. Borderline weird.
He was always fun to be around. He was always in a good mood.
Not egotistical, but he had an ego.
I truly felt that he never meant me any harm, and he always considered me his friend.
There's a facade that Augustus brought. You know, he wanted it to be true, even though, you know, basic human logic would tell you otherwise.
First thing, when he first came to me, I thought he was joking.
I think liars are people who distort things. I think liars are people who purposefully hurt people through distortion. And Augustus never set out to hurt anyone at all with his stories.
Schizophrenic? I don't know if he would be considered schizophrenic. Maybe. Probably.
Augustus was a youthful soul, and he had a poetic and sometimes beautiful vision of life, of his life.
He was ready to give way. His mental state was ready to give away at any moment.
I think he's kind of a loser. No, I mean, I looked at it like how do you help like a drug addict that wants to keep using drugs? You can be there when they're ready to like get rid of it.
Even as he walked away, he was alone. He was a lonely man. In a state of confusion.
Well, thank you so much for letting us come into your house and stuff.
I appreciate y'all coming in. This is great. I have to admit, I'm a little nervous about it.
It's natural.
Yeah. I don't typically have this many people in this room. I never do. I never have this many people in this room. When I did them YouTube videos on this chair, just with me, sitting here. And Tommy was sitting, you know, right here, about where you're sitting.
Uh-huh.
I had no idea it took this many people to make a movie.
Part of why we're interested in doing the documentary about you is, you know, that from some of the things that you're claiming are kind of outlandish.
because my skin maybe is normally a different color than most people, I like to just cover my skin because I look a little strange, I think. And I don't want to shock people. I don't want them to think, what's wrong with him? I could walk around without a wig, or I could just walk around and be whatever, but it's good to kind of make people feel comfortable. In general, I think that's just part of being proper and part of being polite, which I like to do. That's just part of being a good person. On these stairs, they can get a little creaky for one thing, is for sure.
Watch your step there with that, all this.
I think y'all are gonna be surprised. Like, all the stuff I have in this room. Like, I got a lot of collections and things. I think it's gonna surprise y'all. You know what them are from? One of them comes out of every box of tea. So I've been collecting them for years. Now, I don't drink the tea myself, but Tommy will drink the tea occasionally. This is of that big red gate right on into Chinatown, you know that? You see that? It has these little forks. I just think it's pretty. I don't use it for anything, but I just like the fact that it's a pineapple. Montesquieu, my friend, Robert Montesquieu, he's counting. I can't tell you how much I have talked into this. I was here during this fair, this exposition they called it, Paris, year 1900. I could tell looking at you, you don't believe me. It's the kind of thing people would not believe. So. That's all right. I'll just tell you what I have experienced from my point of view.
Great.
When I was so ashamed for what I'd done, suddenly it hit me hard. And I left the county, and I left the state, and I started wandering around I started wandering around the country. It was a dark period for me. It was very depressing being in that state of mind, not knowing what I was. Especially with my background, it was very confusing. And I had an opportunity to get on a boat at a point in time. I saw that I could get on a boat and go to Paris. For me, coming from where I live, I would promise you that at that time, I promise you almost that like Walt Disney had been there because it looked like a distant land. Seriously, like they had like a little Arab world, a little, you know, Spain world, Italy world. And it just went on and on and on this way. That was the first time I'd ever seen a movie was at that place, at that exposition, they called it. They had these sidewalks that had been moving. You'd stand on them, it'd take you from one end to the other. So people did not even have to walk. That was something else.
Sounds exciting.
I'll say it was exciting. It was amazing for me to see all of this. It was like going to the future, and it went on for a whole year. It was like living in the future for a whole year. You go on into this building, and there's a boat inside a building. It was like a ride. It was like a Disney ride. It would take you on a voyage. You know, what you ought to do is just bring up another chair here. I think no, they would like you to
no room.
Sit
there's
down.
No chairs.
They're here now. They want you here.
Yeah, that's why I got...
Don't you? Well, what do you have to do that's so important? I mean, don't you want them? Come on.
We'd love to have them.
Yeah.
You know I don't want to do this,
man. Well, I know you said that. This is a little awkward to discuss this now.
I'm sorry, everybody. Just don't film me. I'm awkward. I'm sorry. I'll see you later, Augustus.
Well, I'll see you later, okay? I mean, he's... He's a very nice person, all right? You being here is a good thing. I'll talk to him tonight.
After we die, I think that there's another planet beyond us.
I believe that we never die. I believe that we just transform into another state.
That has been set aside in the solar system.
That's a beautiful place to be with God, and there's no hurt, no pain.
I believe that this is a place to learn, and once we finish learning, we go to the next level of life.
Happiness.
For us to likewise partake.
Yeah, I'd like it for like maybe the first 100 years.
I think I get bored, to tell you the truth. After a couple thousand years, I kind of run out of things to do.
I believe in that there is life after death, but it's in God's eternal kingdom.
I mean, immortality in heaven is, you know, after this.
Boring.
And you don't live on, you don't go anywhere, you're just a dead person. Wherever they put you, that's where you are.
I was born 1856. Which was a little bit before the Civil War. And that does sound strange. I guess if I was just a normal person walking around, I would not believe that. I think that was crazy. I think maybe just the idea that I am gonna be living just day after day forever. You know, when you are immortal. You ain't never gonna end. Knowing that is not a comforting fact. You know, everybody's always talking. They're looking for the fountain of youth. I don't care how nice it is. It's not a comforting idea for, it's frightening, it's terrifying. I don't want that. You can sit here for as long as you want, just sort of watch with people coming and going. There's some lovely people here. There's one lady at the counter, Christian is her name. I swear, she is so sweet, like, kind of sweet like an angel. That's how I imagine her. So this is one of my places I go. I have many places that I go.
Well, I've never said anything out loud. But I've always wondered why. Like, maybe is he bald? Has he had cancer? Is he hiding from someone? His mannerisms, I like watching those, actually. Doesn't it intimidate any of the girls that work here or anything? And he seems to be really polite. And he leaves us a tip.
Tommy don't come. He and I spend more time together just back at the house. You know, which is good. That's a good time to spend together. You know, it's quiet.
Tommy.
I'll just come back later, it's no big deal. No, it's just a thing, it's your guys' thing. It's not, I mean,
I'm just wondering how long you've lived with Augustus and why you're so, you know.
Yeah, he knows all that. You don't have to film me. You don't ever have to film me. Me? You don't ever have to film. You don't have to follow me either. You can stay up there and you can leave me alone.
He's just moody sometimes. He's sometimes like that. And I guess I'm just more used to it.
It's understandable that he's, you know, he's shy around the camera. He doesn't want us in here.
Well, I don't think it's understandable. Hey, I mean, it ain't understandable from a politeness point of view. He's kind enough when it's just me and him. He's just frightened. He's just fearful, that's all. Sometimes he'll leave here, even when I'm here with him. He'll leave like, you know, a couple of days and won't come back. It frightens me. And I'll get on to him about it, but he is like that. Now, don't you touch that. I don't want you to touch that. When I was living with Andy for a while, he was doing them paintings of all them celebrities, right? And I thought, well, he could maybe do one of me. I asked him. Maybe, Andy, you could do one of me. He'd gotten sort of uppity at that point, and I asked him that question. He just picked up this can sitting around the place there where he worked. He just picked it up, dipped it in the paint, right? He said, there's your artwork. Like I was to be satisfied with that. I knew right then that was the end of our relationship. I kept it. This here is that arc I was telling you about. And you can see this tall fella right there. That's Paul Satko, and he's the one who had this idea. He was building them wheels. It was all on this big vehicle, and he was about to take it across the country, which he eventually did, and I went with him. So this is me and my dog, and his name was Napoleon, but he died fairly recently. But it's okay, he was a great dog. He's so sweet. For me, that is my memory of my mom. Just looking at that photo. I don't remember her face. I look at that and that is my memory. I heard the explosion. I saw that Godzilla movie. I was around. I remember the ship coming down and you could take that gun. Somebody would take it and shoot me. You know that feeling you get on Christmas Day? That's what I felt. It was like just the happiness, just pure happiness. So what this is here is what I have remembered of my family when I left South Carolina. I want to work out everyone else, and I plan to. Tommy had been telling me, you know, oh, you don't need to do that. What's the purpose of doing that? You know, I've been living up here, right? If I'm going on down far enough, I'll find someone, perhaps, that's living in this time period today, and I could meet them.
I'm Nicole High. I met, I guess, a couple years ago, and just kind of a casual friend of his.
Where'd you guys meet?
On the street, actually. I was admiring a bit of his wardrobe, and that was it. So,
you like the way he dresses?
Yeah, love it. It's fantastic. I love his house. It's a little corner of, you know, an abandoned hotel, but he makes it into something else entirely. I think that he inhabits his own universe. I don't think that it necessarily matches up with ours, but that it's not destructive to others, and I don't think it's destructive to him either. He definitely has always wanted his story to be told.
She asked me, would you like to have a computer? I think you would like a computer. You could record yourself and put it on to these YouTube things. And so she's the one who brought this computer here, got me all set up on this.
So it is capturing me at this moment.
Yes.
Like I'm being recorded or... I got this around 1950.
It's hard to point this thing. Some of my things here.
She seems like a sweet, flat young lady, and I think to go and shave off all that pretty hair. I'm so liking you two. I believe in fate. I like that kind because kind of like that sweet. Kind of, I guess I'm a loner is what you'd say. Look what she does. She don't hardly wear no clothes at all. I sort of just can take some of that electricity that they have in their basement. I got a cord sneaking up. I think that's about it. I have my camera. I can record everything about me, which is a new thing for me. And I have only up until now been able to record my life on paper, drawing my pictures, and doing my reel-to-reel tapes, which I've been doing for a number of years, like 50 years or so. And this computer technology, it don't take no room at all. It's like just out in some place, which I like a lot better. There ain't no question about it. But you can see how much room. Look at all of this stuff I have to carry around with me. And I will. I'll carry it around forever. Goes on, like, right on in here.
Uh-huh.
I got everything in here. You just mentioned something that you want to see, because it's in here, I guarantee you.
Let's see. Is that a certain bike that you actually saw?
Yeah, I saw that. Of course, I don't remember where because I didn't write it down. Now, certain things in here, I do remember where. Just seeing it.
It's like an archive of your memory.
That's right, that's right. And I did visit this place. You know, maybe that's where I saw the bicycle. Think of this is sort of like myself. I mean, you can't separate this from me. This is me. You know, this is everything I've lived is right here. Tommy knows to stay away from here. Which he does. And this is the one area of the house that no one ever comes or touches. And by no one, I guess I mean Tommy. You know, he don't like to communicate much. You know, maybe because he's young. He don't want to be communicating, maybe, like he should. And it's something about young people. A lot of young people don't communicate as much. And he'll get over that as he gets older. I think what is happening, me and Tommy, maybe I hope to mentor him to a certain extent. Tommy, why don't you come on in here? They would like to see you. I don't know where he is. You ought to put those cameras on. You ought to put those over on him.
Words to describe Augustus, I think. You know, he could be controlling. He could belittle people. He's very generous. He had a sense of pride, perhaps arrogance. I'm not angry at Augustus at all. I don't regret any decision. He couldn't just stop and look at what was happening.
I've been nicer than them. They tried cornering me in the hallway, man. It was weird. It was like there was like a gang of them. There's like a mob of them. It's not right. Like, it's not a natural thing they do. I mean, I'm not here to ruin your thing. I know you like, you know, whatever, the glamour of it all or whatever, but...
You're not happy for me.
I am happy for you.
No, this is not... What you're saying right now is not what is coming out of your mouth. It's not the truth. I can tell when you don't tell the truth. There's something about your eyes.
That's it.
What is this with the shoes? What is this?
I don't know.
Just putting on shoes, taking them off, like you're not even respecting me one bit. You know, if you're going to have a conversation... conversation in here. That's one thing. Let's have a truthful conversation with each other. Just, you know, let's stop and talk, okay? Let's be a little respectful to one another.
Okay.
We
You come run, go running out of the building, it ain't going
I'm not a part of it. They're going to edit me out.
They aren't going to edit you out. They want to talk to you, okay? So you ought to stay here because they would like to see both of us. And that's why they came. They didn't come just to see me. And if you are going to come, don't just running off and I don't use the language like you were using. Part of being a good host is not running out.
Then what are they doing right there? That's the kind of crap I'm talking about. Man, and you just let them do this in our house.
Well, they're trying to record things. I just know.
Get
the...
Ah!
I'll tell you the story if you just let me tell it in my own order.
Go ahead.
I see a man, he's standing up on a balcony, white balcony. And I could tell just by looking, he was a wealthy man. Cigarette, green velvet. I known right then and there something different about him. I did not know at the time what it was, but I know something is a little strange. What is it? I figured out later what it was. It was he had the aura, is what it is called. It's not a glow or nothing like that. I think that was what most people would expect. Oh, like some green glow or something. It's not nothing like that. His name was Robert Montesquieu. So that's a pretty big thing in my mind, to meet someone that is a count. To just be able to move into the house of a count. And then to become close friends with a count. That's amazing to me that I could do that. And we became very close friends. He'd take me around town, wherever he went, we could talk. Or we would go out to a party. And he could just translate everything for me. And he was like that. He was very kind in that way.
Were you guys in love?
Well, I loved him. You know, of course I loved him.
That was my first take on it, hearing what he thought he was, who he thought he was, that the man is crazy. I mean, there's a definite instability going on. I just feel sorry for whoever that person was, the embodiment of Augustus Gladstone and everything that he was, became, etc.
We can get combs this big any place in town. You only paid for a single scoop. Yes, but we're relatives.
Marsha, look at those skimpy cones. That's no way to treat the family. Let me have them. Give me the cones here. I'll take them.
Could be more different or better. Television or TV or movies.
Why don't you try a seat at the table?
There used to be better.
Mr. Haskell, maybe it's not the room. You're here morning, noon, and night.
I guess I like, reality television the most. Or sometimes I watch one of them, like old films. Maybe one of them old musicals or something. Watch a lot of them old musicals.
So, where am I going to find a helper as good as you?
Well, I know someone very much like me, and he does need a job.
Someone close to you?
Close enough to be my brother. In fact, it is my brother.
I'm a little biased because Tommy and I didn't get on too well. So I would say he's better off now, just because the relationship was fairly, I don't know. A little obsessive, a little codependent. So I don't know, he's definitely hurting because of it. But I'm kind of glad to have my friend back, so I don't know.
How you doing today, Augustus?
I'm doing all right. I'm doing fine. That's how I try to look at things. It's good. It's a good day today. I had a good walk here.
Are you upset about Tommy leaving?
Not for any reason at all. And he will come back, I know it. Because he gets in his little huffs. Typically, he will maybe sometimes will go running off. Now, I ain't ever seen him so angry as that, to be honest with you. He said he would be upset about it. He said he didn't want you coming, but I didn't think he'd get so upset about it. Nothing. I ain't really that upset about it, to be honest. I really don't care. Because if he was going to be so angry and so rude, then I really don't want him around.
Augustus, who's Jimmy Chen? Do you know somebody named Jimmy Chen?
I don't know what that has to do about nothing.
I'm just wondering if
I don't know what that had to do about nothing.
We found some mail that looked like you guys used to live together. Same address.
I don't see how it matters to this, all right?
Time when I was younger, I believed a lot of weird things. I believed in, you know, tooth fairy, vampires. Delusions can be fun when you're young. I think Augustus created his own misery. That's what happens to people that believe in things that aren't true. Well, I've always liked listening to people's stories, like listening to old people talk. And his stories were interesting. I'm somewhere else right now. I'm working actually right now. No hard feelings, but I don't really care what he's doing right now. I went around believing for a couple years and some silly, you know, hocus pocus and wasted my time. Wasted my heart. You know, got a lot of better things to do in my life.
Well, the building is vacant. And as long as it is vacant, it doesn't have to meet the standards of occupancy. The man that you're following creates a more difficult situation because he's actually clean, neat, orderly, and a good guy. And we're just forced to evict him. You know, if it weren't for all of the requirements, I'd make him the guy who takes care of the building or something, but we can't do that because we don't meet any of the standards. The man you're talking about has done a very nice job in cleaning up the space he's in and making it very habitable, but the rest of the building still counts. Trips down the stairs, hurts himself, starves to death because he can't move. That's pretty ugly. Just dies in his sleep and no one knows he's there. That's ugly. We cannot have someone living in a substandard building. We are liable for them. As you noticed earlier, there's been notices on the doors, and those are the things the steps we have to go through for a tenant process. There will be a car with lights that pull up in front. Some guys in light blue sun suits with little badges on them will get out. They will escort him out of the building, and they will take all of his assets and put them on the sidewalk. And that will be that, and we will secure the building. It's not like he's late in his rent. He never paid it.
Been working out a little bit of my family tree, which I've been able to do because I found this website that helps you find parts of your tree, parts of your family. So they've been giving me little bits of information on different parts of my family. You saw me a little while ago. I was working hard sitting at the computer. And I bet there's a whole bunch of people there at that website. I know they must be working long hours to dig up all that information. But I sure do appreciate it because I didn't even know I had all these people in my family. I am sort of doing backwards than everyone else, where I am the old relative looking up people alive today. Which you can do through this. It just takes a little bit more effort, so to speak.
Van Helsing, now that you have learned what you have learned, it would be well for you to return to your own country.
I prefer to remain and protect those whom you would destroy.
You are too late.
Anybody that, I guess, falls under the criteria of drinking blood, I guess, could be considered a vampire.
Technically, I guess they're dead.
You know, they run out 20 teeth and...
They don't like crosses, you kill them with a stake, I think they don't like silver.
Oh, I don't think they exist.
To me, a vampire is an unscrupulous person who has no moral principles. They get on you and...
Bite people.
And they don't show up in mirrors and stuff.
Vampires? Nah. No.
And I once worked as a cook in a kitchen. And I had a guy come in saying that he was a vampire and he needed raw meat.
I think some people actually think they're vampires and they actually drink blood and they actually think it does something for them. There was that one historical woman that used to bathe in the blood of virgins and stuff.
There's a possibility, of course. Anything's possible.
I don't believe in that.
And actually, I actually met a person that actually had their two teeth filed.
That's a vampire. That's a vampire.
There's a disease that
My mom worked with somebody who, they need blood to live.
And would actually have to eat people to compensate for it because they get sores and they were photosensitive and things like that. But I think that's about as far as it goes.
Nothing talks about it in the Bible, and so.
There's a lot of vampire stuff going around.
You know, it took me a long time to be able to get myself to come forward and talk about it to other people. I'd never talk about this to other people. Never do. Montesquieu and I, Count Montesquieu and I, we never spoke of it to anyone. Except to other vampires. You know, one of the things he told me that he had read is that in olden times, vampires were thought to be servants of Satan. That they would go around, and that's why they killed vampires, because they actually believed that they would protect Satan. Now, is that true? Am I a servant of Satan? When I first heard that, when he first told me that, I had to think about that. I had to deal with that because all of this was new all at once. So I had to think. I'm a good person. And that is not me.
So you're saying you don't eat anything, you don't drink anything but blood?
Or plasma is more what a vampire really desires is plasma. Blood is better, you know, for the desire, but plasma is what you need.
So you don't eat anything throughout the day?
I do not eat a thing.
Do you actually kill people?
No, I would never do such a thing. Now, I want everyone to know I would never even consider doing such a thing.
How do you get plasma then? How do you get the blood?
Well, I just don't want to be talking, you know, just saying everything like that, just like going off.
That's fine.
Some things you won't keep private. You have this idea that vampires are all perfect and beautiful. Well, they ain't. Some of them are wearing glasses, like you're wearing glasses. There's some vampires who have severe pains.
I've never heard about that.
I've met some old vampires. Some of them are maybe a little fat. Some of them have epilepsy. I have normal teeth. I mean, just they're normally shaped teeth, and every vampire does. Is a vampire really going to be scared of crosses or needles through the heart, stake through the heart, burn with lye and everything? There ain't hardly any ways to kill a vampire. There are just one, there's one basic way you can easily do it, you know.
How's that?
Well, it's just the idea that there is, you know, I can say that there is a way like that, but there might be. I don't know where this is going to be shown.
We don't know either, really.
Right. I kind of accidentally heard this, and I maybe shouldn't have. But if anybody watching this is sort of a younger vampire or even an older one, maybe they should not hear that. So I don't feel comfortable saying.
That's fine. I respect that. Do you know any other vampires? Right now in your life, are you friends with other vampires?
I have known other vampires. At this point in time, over the years, I want to stay away maybe sometimes. From certain times in my life, I have felt the need to maybe stay away. There was like a time I actually had like a group of people I met with on a regular basis that were vampires. We'd all sit and just express things. You know, what are we feeling? It allowed us to all get it all out. It was helpful for a while, but you know, some of the people in that group, I mean, there was particularly one person. I forget his name. Reuben. And some of the things he would always bring up, they weren't things I needed to hear. almost like a obsession. Going overboard, you know. I don't know, nothing mattered. Feeling the need to shove it in all of our faces. And just week after week, it brought me down. I couldn't be around that anymore. I mean, yeah, I feel sorry for him, you know. But he weren't gonna change.
It's probably, I don't know, maybe the myth that appeals to him most that he can identify with. And so, can be confusing for people. And it's not like anyone is taking it face value.
Eventually he did tell me he was a vampire. And I don't think it was something he was hiding or anything. So I probably knew within a couple weeks. He seemed like he believed it, whether it's true or not. You know, I think I wanted to believe also. You know, I still wish that was true, you know. Yeah, I think I had happy delusions, you know. If I could be something immortal or legendary, you know, I'm gonna do whatever I can to do that, you know, and was not the highlight of my life. It's not a good chapter of my life.
I just love to come here, relax, you know. It's beautiful because it's very different from like if when you are in the city, you know, the sun on the trees, the grass, it smells different even. It just feels so nice.
Why'd you bring the book, Augustus?
You know, it's just what Montesquieu gave me is this. And you hold an object in your hand, those little snatches kind of come back to you.
Hey, Augustus. Joe and I were talking. We thought it might be interesting if we went along with you to for a doctor's visit.
I don't have no doctor's visit.
We were thinking if you would be willing. You know, we could set up an appointment and go and maybe follow you along for an exam.
You think they would be able to, like, maybe help my epilepsy or something?
I don't honestly know. You know, when was the last time that you went to a doctor?
Well, I ain't been to a doctor.
You know, I don't appreciate that at all in this younger generation. Now, you meet an older person on the street, I tell you, they would say something like they say, they call you sir, or, you know, if you was a woman, they'd call you ma'am. That used to happen a long time ago. You'd walk into a store, and they'd say, hello, sir. Hello, ma'am. Good morning, sir. Good morning, ma'am. That used to happen. You know, it was just the polite thing to do. And it was the friendly thing to do. I think we have lost a lot of things. I lost a lot in our culture because we don't do that no more. Over the generations, we've taken a step backwards. I don't know what made me think of talking about that. Just popped into my head.
You just bumped into me.
So if we're just working on this lighting right now, Christian, let's do that. Right.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like it's pretty much there.
Let me look.
On something.
Okay. So.
More or less subtle.
You know what, I forgot it. Oh, I have set up something for you. This is, we ought to go on. Can you gather everyone together?
Yeah.
We ought to do that right now. We ought to gather everyone together right now because I had set up something. We ought to do that. Come on. Here, all we need is a few flashlights. I always have these.
It's right on up here, just a couple floors.
Come on. What are you waiting for? Come on.
Now you're gonna like this a lot more than an interview, I know that.
We sit and do them interviews all the time, and this is going to be much more interesting.
This is going to be quite a surprise. I had prepared this earlier. Here used to be the old elevator, and it ain't working no more. Just a few more steps.
Sleepy lagoon, a tropical moon, and two on an island. A sleepy lagoon and two hearts in tune in some lullaby land. The fireflies gleam, reflects in the stream, they sparkle and shimmer. A star from on high falls out of the sky and slowly grows dimmer. The leaves from the trees all dance in the breeze and float on the ripples. We're deep in a spell as nightingales tell of roses and dew. The memory of this moment of love will haunt me forever. A tropical moon, a sleepy lagoon, and you.
So, Augustus, looks like you have getting closer to completing the painting.
No, I finished it. I finished this painting. Now, I finally put in the lines, which were, for me, the hardest part. It's the most detail of it. Don't take me much time to get any painting done, because it's not like I'm a master of this or nothing. But this one was a little hard for me. I think it turned out pretty good. Didn't it?
Yeah, I like it.
Think of it? It's right downtown here. It's like the gate to the Chinatown area. If you should go there, it's a gorgeous area. I did these areas here. It's probably these lines. You've been on either side. You see them if you go there. I maybe need to work a little bit more on those, but. Now, it's a little complicated looking.
Yeah.
You go on follow through here. You go to right here. On the wall, Lucky Gladstone. Well, I found him with this website who gave me all this information, and they just kept giving me more and more. It ain't been that long, but it's been starting to grow really quickly, pretty quickly. I asked him to be my friend, and he said, you know, it's through that whole way you do it. So, yeah, I got to see all his photographs and everything. I don't know him or nothing. For me, that is some, like a culminating moment for me, you know, to have that. Seriously, just finding that he is there. I mean, I have family alive.
You know how you do when you getting ready to do something you ain't prepared for? You sort of, like you telling yourself, I'm getting ready for it, I'm getting ready for it. But I ain't exactly looking forward to it, but, you know, I have to prepare myself, like in my mind, a bit for it. I might be a little, maybe a little nervous about it. Because I don't know him. I don't know what his intentions are. But I'm willing enough to, you know, talk to them and see what they want to see.
You okay? Can I check your pulse at the same time here? Bright light here. Sorry about that. Open your mouth all the way. Say ah.
Ah.
Just try to keep your balance. Maybe we'll go towards the wall this way. You said you're not taking any supplements or any other medications. Nobody's giving you anything to take.
No, I ain't.
We have to be concerned about vitamin deficiencies, toxins, things like this too, but it's a little unclear, and he's had the seizures also. So I'd like to get an EEG, a brainwave test, and then a couple of blood tests, something to look at the thyroid function and...
You want me to take the blood out of my
Just arms? A little bit of blood, right. You go to the lab and they take a little bit of blood too.
I don't agree to that. I don't want that.
Is it a religious or a...
I just don't want no needles in me.
They're really good in the
lab. I don't care if they're good or bad. I don't want it. I don't want no needles in me. What? Said they weren't going to do that.
Well, he doesn't.
Doesn't sound like he's consenting. So, is that how vital is the blood test for giving?
Well, we can start. You're okay with the EEG test.
You can do your EEG. I think that will make for a good movie. You can film that and make for a good movie.
It's not about the movie. But
this will make all. Yeah. This will make for the good movie.
We should just be seeing his background awake activity. And
are you seeing my brain on the screen now?
So we just need you to, can you rest your head back? For a few minutes we need you to just keep your hands off of your head because that's going to interfere with things.
All right. No, please.
And this will just show us the overall brain activity, how well the brain's functioning in general.
I appreciate if you didn't touch my head, all right?
Sure. You've had seizures, so we want to see if there's any abnormal electrical activity with the seizure focus also.
This stuff on my head is like I got a... like stretchy feel, like it's all drying up, you know.
We're not getting
a good recording yet. If you're going to be moving.
You're doing great. You know what? But we just need a little bit of quiet time.
Just get your hand away from me.
A little bit of quiet time.
I don't think I can do this test if he's going to be like this.
Okay.
Just do it. Okay, this is fine. They're filming it, all right? Do it now. I bet you'd never done one of these, because if you had, you wouldn't have been doing it to other people.
No, but we just need you to keep your
interest. You know, that's one of the things that doctors don't, you know. I am being calm.
We're gonna get it working.
I don't think it's working.
I don't like this.
We're gonna figure it out.
Can we stop this now?
He's not right. Well, he seems to have this fixed delusion that he is very, very old. He thinks he doesn't eat or drink. He needs to see a psychiatrist if he hasn't already. I mean, and they may be able to help him, and there may be medications that will help him with his thinking. But I'm concerned that there's more to it than that. It seems that he may have something metabolic going on. His thyroid may be off. He may have had some toxic exposure. His heart rate is very slow. He's pale. He looks awful. He's got the hair loss. I think he has an undiagnosed condition, and we need to try to help him find out what that is and to treat it.
He never even had done that to himself.
Look at Augustus. He's got a bunch of wires up to his head. You know, that will be interesting, but... I've run into other people who have thought that about me, and I've told them I ain't sick. If you would just accept it, you might be a little happier, because you'd accept a lot of things. You know, you ought to turn them cameras off. You ought to turn them off. But family is important. And I don't have none. So, I like to look at the picture of my mama. I don't like all this, you know, I'm gonna write you on the internet over from far distance. I don't like the way that's done. I think that modern way of doing things is too modern. It's not personal. And if I'm gonna see my relative, my own relative, my flesh and blood, I need to do it eye to eye. That's the way to do it. Because then we could have the potential of having a real flesh and blood relationship and a friendship. He's my family. So I am going to find my family down there. To find Lucky. I ain't never flown once. This'll be the first time I've flown on an airplane.
Kidding.
No, I am frightened of that. I've heard of it, but I ain't ever been on an airplane.
Is he expecting you? Does he know anything about you, Augustus?
I ain't contacted him, but if I go down there and just sort of see him, maybe approach him, tell him, hello, I am your relative. I want to see him before I communicate with him in any way. I want to, you know, be there and see him. That's the best way to get in touch with him. I've never been to Las Vegas. I ain't looking so much forward to that because I've heard about it. You know, there's lots of gambling and all kinds of things I don't exactly approve of there, you know? But I'm pretty darn certain that Lucky is not gonna be involved in that because I just know he won't. I know he won't, but I can't wait to get there.
Augustus, are you okay with us taking the crew and following you, going along to Vegas?
I'd love for you to come. I'm flattered for you to come. I'll say thank you ahead of time for you to come.
I hope you're ready in there. I got a little something, just a little something.
It ain't much at all. You go ahead and take that. You know, you can just take these off.
Okay.
Yeah. You know.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for saying that.
That's so nice.
You know, I wrapped it up with some pieces of paper.
Well, thank you for letting us in in your place and...
No, I appreciate y'all coming.
Inviting us in your house.
It's been my pleasure. Stuff. It's been my pleasure. Because it was an honor to have all y'all here. And so I just want to say that you have all, every single one of you have been so kind, so polite, and I have not heard a word of complaint out of all y'all here. I have seen you. You work like the Dickens. And I've never seen a group of people like you. You just have been the friendliest people, and to have you here was an honor to me. And just to be able to have now some more people that I get to have as a memory here, I will never forget this time that I had. I don't know what I'll say. I mean, my nerves are just jumping right now just thinking about it. You know, my name is Augustus, something like that. Hi there, my name is Augustus Gladstone, and we have the same last name, and I'm related to you, that sort of thing, you know. You know, I'll just introduce myself is what I'll be doing, is just sort of saying to him. I'll say my name, I'll shake his hand. I'll show my photograph I have. So, it's hard to know when it comes right on down to it. Sort of get settled in and maybe walk around a little. And give me some time. To get settled, sort of see this place. Hello there. Lucky, my name is Augustus Gladstone, and I am related to you, right? That's what I'll do. That's what, you know, I'll shake his hand. That's what I'll do.
I think if you thought about it, this is sort of like Christmas morning, but a city. It's like red, green, every color, right? It is modern. It feels modern to me, like the future. This is like the future, in a way, that I have never seen, except maybe a couple times in my life. So I'm liking it, which I did not expect.
Glad you came.
I am glad I came, and I even started looking for Lucky, but I'm glad. I love the colors of this place.
I think he's working down.
Well, I ain't going in there. Huh?
No.
See him.
I don't think so. That's not Lucky.
That's not him.
It's not your relative.
What am I supposed to do?
He's gonna come.
I don't think that's
Excuse me, sir.
Yes?
My name's Augustus Gladstone.
Are you okay?
I think I'm related to you.
Look.
Are you with these guys?
They're filming my story. They're filming me. I think actually we're related.
What is this?
This is your photograph.
Guys,
please, I just want
filming.
To talk to you what for a you little while.
About? What are you filming?
Please, they're just filming my story because I've been trying to find some family for a long time.
No,
please.
This
is a nice fellow.
You know the way you look? We are not related. I'm just some guy you find on the street and I'm related to you. Just because
I know we are, actually.
You have black
I know we
blood.
Are.
Just
seriously.
Because, wait,
no.
Just because
have,
you have
I've
black
done a
blood.
Lot of research and it's
you,
what
you
do is explain
you need
to
stop
you. It will
what
not
you're
take
doing.
Long. I have done some research on the internet.
What does it say?
You know? Is your name?
You just meet somebody who, you know,
name?
You come filming me
is
because
your name?
He find me on the street and I'm related
is
to you.
Is your name Lucky Gladstone?
I'm not lucky. I'm very unfortunate even just to meet you. You can film all you like because you don't seem to understand English.
Hey.
We were trying to document his story, and this was a, you know, a turn that he had taken.
I can't confidently say whether a documentary film crew should intervene in the life of somebody else.
While the crew, I think, was still sort of seeing the project as ultimately a work of entertainment, you know, it ended up obviously having real life effects.
Well, Michelle, we've been through this. You know, we're duplicating prior discussions. It's necessary because it's the law. You know, sanitary standards, water, electricity, lights, power, all the things that need to be there in today's society for a basic, safe standard of living. And they aren't there in that building. Building is set to be gutted and redone from the studs in. If we allow them to be there, we have to meet those standards. End of discussion. Not up to further interpretation.
Oh, this looks familiar. You could probably get in there with a pry bar.
What about this?
Bolt cutters.
There's like a string on it.
Go for it. Broken glass, throw a rock. Rock is free. I have my phone off.
And he's asking me to break into the hotel.
There is no project. I mean, it's done. We filmed.
Not very professional of you.
There's nothing for you to do.
You don't give a shit about him.
It's not that I don't
give a shit about Robin. You don't give a shit about Augustus. You don't want to see the project too. It's fine. You know, but
I've seen it through.
You want to see a budget jump? Imagine paying for all the fucking legal fees for a crew full of people.
Go back and find Jimmy Chen, or go and like try and find Tommy.
Yes, Misha, I just wanted to give you a quick update. Joe's off the project. We just had a discussion and he's done. I made some flyers and we're gonna take those up and put them around the areas where Augustus used to hang out. And we've got everybody else standing down for the time being. I mean, I don't know what else to do.
I have not seen him probably at least a week, maybe even longer. He's one you would know if he was here or not. I haven't, you know, really gave much thought. It gets so busy in here, so it's hard to concentrate on just one person. But you know, when you're sitting there thinking, wonder where this person's been, then that's when it comes up. Or we'll talk about, we'll ask the other girls, have you seen this person? Or I wonder where this person's been, or what happened? Did you do something to make him mad? Or did we wait on him fast enough?
There's a saying that goes, never argue with a fool. People will never notice the difference. The fact remains that it was illogical for him to think that I am a relative of his. We have never met, we have never had any connection. So to try and have sense in our conversation with him just adamantly insisting that we are related would never make any sense. I would suggest that character needed a mental assessment. Because he must be suffering from some kind of mental delusion. He believes he's a vampire. Then I would ask him to look in the mirror. Far-fetched, man.
I want to start over. I just don't want anything that I used to have. I moved somewhere else, and I'm hanging out with other people now and stuff. And I'm not like you guys. I don't have all the answers, all right? I don't know how to make everything look and to make everything sound perfect. I'm not like that, all right? I don't even like that. And you guys made him think that it's all of this, and it's bullshit, and it's fake, and it's phony. Have you ever lost every single one of your friends and you don't have any home to go to? Have you? It's not fun. It's not fun to not have anything and to start over. I don't know. I don't know, I'm gonna start my life over again.
Fun to be around. He was always in a good mood. I mean, he was like a little kid. Yeah, I'm gonna miss the guy.
He was completely original and sort of heartbreaking.
I spot something unique in all of them that has kind of something a little funny about it. I'll think about it and then
just paid me a visit just a couple days ago. Apparently Augustus was sorry that that I felt the way I felt. He really wanted me to forgive him for like hurting me. And that's basically it. And you know, and I did. It's fine. I don't have any hard feelings. Augustus has this very prized possession. It's really important to him, and, you know, I think he wanted to make it better between us, or it was, seemed like a very big moment for him.
We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know, tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that when you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
Happy to know that when you saw